गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ माई न्यू नेक्स्ट ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ 7 एंड टूडे आई विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक पॉलिनेशन एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन इन प्लांट्स एंड दिस टॉपिक इज़ फ्रॉम चैप्टर 12 रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टू एक्सप्लेन दिस टॉपिक्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल गिव यू सम एग्जाम्पल. स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस डायग्राम there are so many examples of living beings. Livings, you all know, all living beings reproduce. Like animals or organism, plant also reproduce. There is two ways in which plants reproduce. In previous session, I will discuss two ways of reproduction. Asexual and sexual mode of reproduction. You all know plants reproduce asexual and sexual mode of reproduction. In sexual mode of reproduction, plants reproduce through seeds and flower is the reproductive part of each plant by which a process fertilization, which means the formation of seeds, and these seeds grow in young plants or plantlets. So students, now I will discuss the reproductive part of plants, and the reproductive part of plant is flower. In previous class you all have read about flower. So students, there are so many parts of flower. First is a green stalk like structure which is known as pedicel. Then a swollen part which is known as thalamus. These are the parts of a flower. To continue the parts of a flower, next are four whorls of a flower. First, green leaf like structure which is known as sepals. Second, colorful attractive part which attracts insect for the process of pollination are called petals. Then the male reproductive part which is known as stamen, and fourth whorl or part of a flower is female part which is pistil. So students, the male reproductive part of a flower is stamen, which comprises of two parts. First is anther and second is flamen. Anther consists of pollen grains, and on maturity this anther burst and pollen grains release into environment. This is the female reproductive part of a flower. This part comprises of three. Topmost sticky part is known as stigma, a tube-like structure which is known as style, and swollen part at the base is known as ovary. This swollen part consists of female gamete, which is known as egg or ovules. So students, after this I will continue the topic fertilization. Fertilization is the process of fusion of male gamete, which is known as pollen grain, with female gamete, which is known as egg or ova. Now when pollen grains fuse with ovules, they form a diploid cell is known as zygote. So students, the process of pollen joining with the ovules present in the ovary is called fertilization. During the fertilization process, when ovules fuse with pollens, then seeds are formed. These seeds grow in soil and convert in new plant. This is the diagram for the formation of seed. After fertilization, ovary swells to form the fruit. Ovary convert into fruit and ovules convert into seeds. And these seeds again grow in soil and give rise to new plant. After the discussion of fertilization, now I come to the point or topic pollination. And students, how do pollens reach the stigma? Pollens reach the stigma by a process of pollination. In this process of pollination, pollen grain come from anther to stigma. This transference of these is known as the term pollination. Students, there are various ways by which pollination occur. Flowers have bright, nutritious, honey-like liquid called nectar inside them that act as food for many insects. And these insects attract towards these colorful petals. So there are so many ways by which pollination occur. First is through insects. Insect attract towards the petals and this process of pollination occur. This process of pollination is of two types. First is self-pollination. Self means same plant. It means the pollination occur between same flower in which male and female part present in same flower. Second is cross-pollination. Occur between two different flowers of same species. This is known as cross-pollination. After this, the types of pollination, the agents of pollination. Agents means the ways or carriers by which pollination occur. There are so many agents of pollination like bees, butterflies, insects, etc. After the agent of bees and butterflies, insects, water is also the agent of pollination by which this process occur. The pollen grains shed in water and they reach to the same flower of same species. Like water, wind is also act as agent of pollination. The light hairy flower pollen grain reach towards the same species. Thank you.